Hello students, today we are going to see practical number 2, that is of PMMC and EMI type instruments. Practical significance: in the industry, electrical engineering diploma holders are expected to handle PMMC and EMI type instruments to measure basic electrical parameters like voltage and current. In some situation, it becomes necessary to identify the faulty components of the instruments. Therefore, this practical will help you to identify components of PMMC and EMI type instruments. Students, by doing this practical, you are going to achieve some competency and practical skill, such as use relevant measuring instruments in different electrical applications, use PMMC and EMI type instruments, and troubleshoot PMMC and EMI instruments. So you can look at the diagrams. First diagram is of PMMC type instrument. It is a PMMC type ammeter. It has scale from 0 to 15 ampere. You can see its scale is uniform, and this symbol, this line shows that this meter is a PMMC type meter. And in another diagram, this is a voltmeter, EMI type voltmeter. By looking at the scale only, by looking at various symbols, you can decide whether this is a AC meter or DC meter, means PMMC or EMI type meter, you can identify. You can see its scale is non-uniform and initially cramped. You know, PMMC meter is a uniform, and scale of the EMI type instrument is non-uniform. So the PMMC stands for permanent magnet moving coil. The PMMC works on the electromagnetic effect. A permanent magnet is used to produce magnetic flux, and a coil that carries the current to be measured moves in this field. As the pointer is connected to the coil, it gets deflected in proportion with the current. Working principle of permanent magnet moving coil meters: where a current carrying conductor placed in the magnetic field experiences force, it is given by the expression which is given below. F is equal to PIL, where F is force in Newton, B is flux in Tesla, I is current in ampere, L is length of conductor in meter. Now students, we will see construction of PMMC type instrument. This type of instruments has a deflecting system, controlling torque, and damping system. The deflecting system consists of a permanent magnet made of alnico, a core of soft iron, and moving coil of enameled copper wire. The moving coil has a thin cross section and about 5200 turns. It is wound on a rectangular aluminum former. The former is pivoted on a spindle. The moving coil is free to rotate in the gap of permanent magnet and fixed core. So students, this deflecting system consists of permanent magnet. Okay, you can see permanent magnet here. These are permanent magnet. It is made of alnico and core of soft iron and moving coil of enamel copper wire. This is inside, core is shown. Here moving coil is shown. It wound on a rectangular aluminum former, and it is pivoted on the spindle. This is the controlling system consists of a spring called control springs made of phosphor bronze. Springs also act as the leads for the currents. Okay, this one and this one are springs made of phosphor bronze. Damping torque is produced by the principle of eddy current. Eddy current damping system generates eddy currents in the permanent magnet and damps the oscillations of indicating pointer by providing force in the opposite direction. So damping torque is produced by the eddy current produced in the permanent magnet. Okay, in this permanent magnet, damping torque is produced. Here in this diagram, you can see internal construction. Okay, this is the pointer shown. This is a horseshoe magnet, upper springs and lower springs, supports for core, then iron core is shown here. Okay, and this is a diagram, black and white. In this diagram, these two springs are shown. Springs are used for controlling system and lead for the currents. Okay, then this moving coil is shown here, and permanent magnets. Okay, this one and this one. Then pointer is shown. Okay, and soft steel ring. So I will proceed now. Now we will see working of PMMC instruments. A deflecting torque is produced proportional to the current through the moving coil which moves in the field of permanent magnet. Control springs produces the controlling torque which is proportional to the angle of deflection. Eddy current circulating in the aluminum former produce damping torque which is proportional to the eddy EMF induced in it. So this is a working principle. So the deflecting torque is produced proportional to the current through the moving coil. This is a moving coil. Controlling spring produces the controlling torque, means these two controlling springs control the movement of the pointer, which is proportional to the angle of deflection. Okay, eddy current circulating in the aluminum former produce damping torque. So students, we will now see working principle of MI type instruments. The MI stands for moving iron. It works on the principle that the iron placed near the magnet attracts towards it. The force of attraction depends on the strength of magnetic field. The magnetic field induces by the electromagnetic whose strength depends on the magnitude of the current passes through it. Now we will see construction of MI type instruments. This type of instrument has deflecting system, controlling system and damping system. Now deflecting system consists of circular coil, a soft iron piece called fixed iron is attached to the coil from inside. A spindle is along the axis of coil. Another soft iron piece called as moving iron is attached to the spindle. Okay, this is deflecting system. Here moving iron is shown. Okay, and this is a spindle. Controlling system consists of springs called control springs made of phosphor wrench. In this MI type instrument also springs are there made of phosphor wrench for controlling system. Damping system consists of air friction damping. So in PMMC type eddy current damping is there, and in MI type air friction damping is there. Here internal construction of MI type instrument is shown. Okay, this is a cylindrical coil, this is a control spring, this one and this one. Moving iron is shown inside and stationary iron segment outside. Okay, pointer is shown. This is construction details of MI type instrument, and here in this diagram again you will have clear imagination. This scale is shown. Okay, then this is winding, coil winding, pointer, moving iron is shown here. W1, W2 and W3, these are weight, this is balance weight and these are control weight. This is air chamber, piston moves forward and reverse. Whenever it moves, air in this chamber have resistance to this piston which generates damping torque. Okay, now we'll see working of MI type instrument. While coil carries current, the soft iron pieces gets magnetized. Similar poles are formed on the nearer faces of soft iron pieces and they repel each other. Thus the deflecting torque is due to the repulsion and it is proportional to square of the current through the coil. Control spring provides the controlling torque which is proportional to the angle of deflection. Air friction damping is provided to the instrument. So damping torque is proportional to move on piston in air chamber. So students, you have seen PMMC type and MI type instruments, its construction, working and working principle you have learned. Now you will have to do practical. Procedure you have to follow in part 1, identification of PMMC type instruments. Here you have to observe the given working model of PMMC type instrument. You have to observe reflecting, controlling and damping system. And you will have to draw sketch showing all parts of the instrument and you will have to label them. Same procedure is followed for identification of MI type instrument, that is part B. Now you have learned theoretical part of the experiment. I will now show you actual meters. Since it is an ammeter, AC ammeter, it will use to measure AC current. Now I will show you scale of this meter. As you can see, scale of this meter is initially cranked. You know, scale of MI type meter is non-uniform. Now I will show symbols mentioned on the meter. Initially IS1248 means according this IS, this meter is manufactured. Then second symbol is of MI type. Then third symbol is of AC. And fourth symbol shows that class of meter, means class of this meter is 1.0. Then this symbol, you can see here, this symbol shows that this meter should be used in horizontal position only. You cannot use this meter like this in vertical position. If you try to use this meter in this position, it will show wrong readings, it will not give proper readings. Then this symbol shows that tested for 2 kV voltage. Then this is a frequency of the AC voltage. As you know, it is a 50 Hertz in India. Then this is serial number of this meter given by the manufacturer. Here these terminals are given. You can see this is a common terminal. You can use this meter either to measure current up to 1 ampere or current up to 0.5 ampere. If your current is less than 1 ampere, you can use this terminal, or if your current is less than 0.5 ampere, you can use this 0.5A terminal. Now children, this is also a meter, but difference is that this meter you should use in vertical position only. If you place this meter, keep this meter in horizontal position, this meter will never give you accurate reading. Okay, all other scales and symbols are similar. Okay, you can see its scale also initially cramped. This symbol shows that this meter is used vertically. Okay, students, now this is a voltmeter, MI type voltmeter. You can see scale of this meter, then all symbols are mentioned here. Previously such box type meters were manufactured. Nowadays you will see such types of meters. Now I will show DC type of meters, that is a PMMC meters. The scale of this meter is uniform. Here each scale is divided uniformly. This is a milliampere meter, means milliammeter. Here DC is mentioned. I will show you symbols. IS1428 means all types of meters, PMMC and MI type meters, are manufactured according this IS. Then second symbol shows that this is a PMMC type meter, means this is a symbol of PMMC. You can see here. Then this is a DC type. This symbol shows that this is a DC type meter. Then class of the meter 1.01 means this shows that this meter is, this shows that class of this meter is 1.0. Then this is a symbol of horizontal position, means this meter also you should use horizontally, you should not use it vertically. Then this symbol shows that again this meter is tested for 2 kV. Then serial number is mentioned. As I told you, serial numbers are given by the manufacturer. Again I will show you here terminals of the meter, positive and negative, means input is given here and output is connected to this terminal. You know, ammeter are always connected in series and voltmeters are always connected in parallel. Now I will show you DC voltmeter. Here you can see holds DC, means this is a PMMC type voltmeter, and it will measure DC quantities, DC voltage. Again you will see scale, uniform scale, as it is a DC voltmeter, as it is a PMMC type meter. Again all symbols are mentioned there. IS1248, this is a PMMC symbol, this is a DC symbol, this is a class of the meter, this is a horizontal position, means this symbol shows that this meter should be used horizontally, and this is a testing voltage, and again serial number. This is a multi terminal meter. You know, voltage is measured across two terminals, phase and neutral in case of AC, and positive and negative in case of DC. These wires, these supply terminals are connected to meter. Here common terminal is shown. If your voltage is less than 75 volt, I will connect my one wire to 75, this terminal. And if voltage is less than 30 volt, I will connect another wire to 30 volt terminal. If my voltage is less than 15 volt, I will connect my terminal to 15 volt terminal. Okay, so this is a voltmeter. So students, I have shown you PMMC meters, MI type meters, voltmeter and ammeter. Now I will show you internal construction of the meter. Okay, this is MI type voltmeter. It is open now. So students, you can see internal construction of this meter. Here this pointer is shown. Here springs are shown. Springs are connected. Okay, and here this is a knob. You can adjust pointer's position. Students, we have learned today PMMC and MI type instruments. We have seen actual meters in the laboratory, its working construction and symbols. We have seen all details about the meters. I hope this video will really be beneficial for you, useful for you. Please like, share videos and subscribe this channel. Thank you.